been an awakening. Can you feel it? Justin.
What's up, Allison?
How did you sleep through that intense intro sequence? There's been an awakening.
Oh.
Can you feel it?
Yeah, I'm awake.
No, not you, the Force.
Oh, the Force,
yeah.
That's right. Today we're gonna have a sneak peek at the Star Wars The Force Awakens.
Let's take a look.
Why are we whispering?
The highly anticipated seventh film in the Star Wars series, The Force Awakens, drops on December 18th, and with it comes the also highly anticipated Star Wars The Force Awakens playset. The Force Awakens playset comes with two new heroes, Finn and Rey.
Finn is a trained warrior with an interesting past, always on the lookout for adventure, while Rey is a resilient survivor, equally up for adventure and infinitely resourceful. Other playable characters include Poe Dameron, a trusted pilot of the Resistance who uses his expert flying skills to travel the galaxy and take out bad guys.
Then there's Kylo Ren.
This guy gives me chills just looking at him.
He's an enforcer for the First Order who specializes in terrorizing the galaxy. The Force Awakens playset and figures will be released just in time for the Force Awakens premiere on December 18th. But you can pre-order them now. Check out our website for more details. It's 11 days until Halloween.
Correct. On a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate my costume?
Wow, well, you've really outdone yourself, Justin. I'm gonna have to go with an 8.5.
My sensors indicate a severe miscalculation. I think my chances of winning the Disney Infinity costume contest are roughly 35.786 to 1.
I don't know, Baymax. If I know Disney Infinity fans, I have a feeling we'll be seeing some amazing costumes.
I cannot deactivate until you explain the contest rules to the viewers.
Right, okay. So to enter, dress up as any Disney, Pixar, Marvel, or Star Wars character in Disney Infinity, then take a photo with that character's Disney Infinity figure.
Upload your photo and submit the form on the Disney Infinity website. The winner gets a Disney Infinity 3.0 Star Wars PS4 bundle. To give you guys ideas for Halloween costumes, we recently met up with YouTuber Keith Lapinick. You're not going to believe his hero costume.
Excuse me while I let out some air.
Please don't.
Hey guys, I'm here with YouTuber Keith Lapinick, and today he's going to show off his sweet Big Hero 6 costume.
Hey guys, so as Allison said, I made a Hero Hamada costume. So over here is the main piece, which is everything I 3D printed, and I have the helmet here, and the shoulder pads, and the knee pads, and the chest piece.
Like, how long did it take you to make all of this?
In total, it took about 3 months to make, and I made this before the film came out. Here are a bunch of clothes that I did not sew myself because I don't know how to sew. However, I did a mock job of sewing for the gloves, which I basically took snowboarding gloves and just sewed foam pieces to it and the purple fabric and a belt that I also did not sew, but I bought on eBay. So over here we have the helmet, which actually took 100 hours to make.
Wow, that's incredible.
Yes, and that's not including the paint job. That was just 3D printing itself.
Is this all one piece?
No, the helmet is actually 9 separate pieces that I had to glue together, sand after it was all glued together. That probably took 100 hours of work on the helmet alone. The chest piece was probably 40, 50 hours, and each other piece was maybe 12 hours.
So Keith, you do a lot of Disney cosplaying, right?
Oh yeah. My first Disney cosplay was Aladdin for a not-so-scary Halloween party a few years ago. But I recently, during the D23 Expo, I dressed up as Ryan Evans from High School Musical, and I also dressed up as Ping from Mulan, which is Mulan dressed up as a guy, and that's a girl dressed up as a guy. So I was a guy dressed up as a girl dressed up as a guy.
Wait, what? Mind blown.
So, Hiro Hamada would not be complete without his Megabot from the beginning of the film. I took this upon myself to do another 3D printing project, and I made it completely functional, where it's magnets built inside my 3D print, and it comes apart.
That is so cool. So So you can put them back together then?
Yep.
Can I?
Everything comes off.
This is amazing. Well, I think we're about ready to see what this thing looks like.
We'll be right back.
All right, it's time for the big reveal. May I introduce to you from Big Hero 6, Keith Lapinig as Hiro Hamada. Fist bump. All right, so tell us about why you chose Hiro.
So I actually made this way before the film came out because I was super excited to finally get the representation that I always hoped for in a Disney film. So I was not disappointed when I finally saw Hiro Hamada on the big screen, and he has really become an inspiration to me because one, he 3D prints, he's very family oriented, and I just really connected to him more than other Disney characters in the past.
So for anybody out there wanting to 3D print a costume like this, like, what's your advice to kids?
Pretty much, if you have an idea, research on how you can accomplish that goal and just make it happen, because I started from not knowing how to 3D print at all, and here I am now.
I'm thinking I should recruit this guy for my Halloween costume. All right, so tune in next week for our Halloween special.
Wow, that was a quick costume change.
Yeah, it was getting a little hot in there.
I bet. Guys, we're headed back to the grid for this week's free Toy Box download.
Tron Legends Korra Story is the sequel to the Sam Flynn Story Toy Box we released a couple weeks back. This time, you're playing the adventure from Korra's point of view. What you didn't see in Sam Flynn's story is that Korra is shot down and lands in the dangerous and wild Outlands.
She has to build a laser to blast through a huge wall to clear her path, battle wild programs, and solve puzzles to escape. She also has to make it through a dangerous energy storm with lightning that blasts holes in the ground.
After getting help from some friendly programs, Korra pilots the light jet to destroy Dillinger's energy nodes, then travels to his citadel.
Together, they pursue Dillinger back to the real world, where he has transformed himself into the boss for the final boss battle. No need to worry though. As long as you have Korra on the base, you've got this.
She's got her identity disc, light grappling hook, and you can even unlock a special move called Last of the ISOs.
Both Korra and Sam Flynn are available for Disney Infinity 3.0 now, and you can download their Tron Legends toy boxes from the community content section of the Disney Infinity 3.0 main menu.
Now let's see what the Disney Infinity community's been up to.
All the Lights and Sounds Instagrammed an epic photo of Obi-Wan in Tomorrowland. He says, "It seems Darth Maul is still pretty bitter about being sliced in half by Jedi Master Obi-Wan Kenobi. Upon seeing Obi-Wan, he proceeded to growl and knock him down with his lightsaber."
Jeez, Darth Maul, way to hold a grudge. On Facebook, John Hughes found a creative way to display his Rise Against the Empire figures, complete with an excavator. Get it? It's an escalator for Darth Vader.
And at Ed DeWiz tweeted a great photo of Han Solo and Chewbacca.
"Chewie, we're home."
That about wraps it up for this episode.
Don't forget to submit your photos for the Disney Infinity Costume Contest for a chance to win that sweet PS4 bundle.
And remember,
if you can dream it,
you can do it.